Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our science session. So in this science session we are discussing our lesson, that is light, shadow and reflection. So up till now we have discussed about the light, also we have discussed about the shadow, conditions of the shadow, characteristics of the shadow. So now we will move for the reflection, okay. But before going to see the reflection, what is meant by the reflection, one more and very interesting point we are going to discuss, that is nothing but what? Pinhole camera. Okay. So what is meant by the pinhole camera? So it is the one type of an instrument which works on the light's travel on a straight manner. Okay. So this is the one type of an instrument, and that phenomena, on which phenomena it works? It works on the phenomena, and the name of that phenomena, or if that phenomena it is what? That light travels on a straight manner, or the light always travels in a straight line. Okay. So let's make a pinhole camera. So we will see one video how to make exactly a pinhole camera. So see the video.
Pinhole camera is a light-proof box with a small hole on one side. Light from an object passes through this hole and projects an inverted image of the object on the opposite side of the box. Let us learn how to make a pinhole camera. Take a cardboard or a tin box. Cut open a side of the box and paste a tracing paper over it. Pierce a very small hole in your center of the side, opposite to the one shown on bright light on your face. The tracing paper has been pasted. He did it with the help of a mirror. Close the box from all the sides. He used the pinhole camera to reflect the sunlight in your direction. Make the pinhole face. This mischief of Amund proves that a mirror changes the direction of light that falls on it. The size of the direction of light by a shiny surface is called reflection of light. The greater the distance between the screen and the hole, the larger the image. The larger the image, the fainter it is. The larger the distance between the object and the hole, the smaller the image.
So just now you have seen that how we can make the pinhole camera and how it exactly works. Okay. So in that pinhole camera we are getting the inverted image. Okay. We are getting the inverted image. So the image from by a pinhole camera, it is what? Inverted image. Why? Because as we know that the light can pass through in a straight manner, or the light always travels in a straight manner. Also we are getting the small image in the pinhole camera. But on the other hand, if we make the big hole in the pinhole camera, then what will happen? More than one rays of the light can pass through that pinhole camera, and it can give the number of the images, and that all the images will get overlapped with each other, and because of that we are getting the blur image in that pinhole camera. Okay, so this is about what? Pinhole camera. But let's see what are the uses of the pinhole camera. So this pinhole camera basically used to observe the distinct object. Now distinct object means what? The objects which are very far away from us. To observe that objects we can use the pinhole camera. Also this pinhole camera we can use to observe the people, those who are walking in a sunlight. Also the pinhole camera is used to observe the solar eclipses. Okay, so these are the uses of pinhole camera. Now we see the next one, that is pinhole camera in nature. So if the pinhole camera is also present in the nature, how is it? On the certain ground we can see the circular structure of the sun. Okay, we can see the circular structure of the sun. How this image of the sun is formed? Because the leaves of a plant is act as a hole, and from that hole only the one rays can pass through, and they can form the image on the ground. Okay, so here you can see how the exactly pinhole camera gives the image of the sun. Okay, so this pinhole camera is also present in the nature. The next one and a very interesting point from the lesson, that is we are going to discuss about the mirror and reflection of light. Now as we know, if you are playing the table tennis or if you are playing the other games, and if we are talking about the ball, if we throw the ball on the wall, then what will happen? That ball will comes again to us, it will bounce back to us. Okay, so like that, same property is followed by the light rays. The light rays falls on an object, and from that object it comes back to our eyes, or it reaches to to our eyes. And that phenomena or that property of the light is called as what? Reflection of light. Okay. So see here, the phenomena of sending back the light rays that fall on the surface of an object is called reflection of light. Okay, so what is meant by the reflection of the light? The phenomenon of sending back the light rays that falls on the surface of an object is called what? Reflection of light. Okay, so now you all are able to see this board. Why you are able to see this board? Because the light rays falls on it and then it reaches to our eyes, and with the help of that you are able to see this board. Okay, so in this way we can say that the light rays can bounce back. It strike on certain object and from that it comes back and reaches to our eyes. That phenomenon is called as what? Reflection of light. Okay, but this reflection of the light is also depends upon the which type of the surface of a object having. So if the object is having the rough surface, then there is a less reflection takes place. Why? Because of that rough and the uneven or irregular surface of an object, all the light rays are getting diverged, okay, get spread in all the direction. But in the other case, if the object is having the plane surface, then all the reflected rays can go in a same direction. Okay, so to understand this phenomena, to understand this activity, this phenomena, we are having one activity. So let's see, go through this activity.
Polished or shiny surface can act as a mirror. Do you know what happens when light falls on a shiny and polished surface such as a mirror? Let us find it out together. Let one person hold a mirror in his hand and stand at one corner of the room. Let the second person stand at the another corner of the room. Let the third person hold a torch and cover the glass of the torch with fingers and switch it on. Let him get a beam of light by leaving a small gap between the fingers so that light can pass through that. Let him direct the beam of the torch light onto the mirror that the first person is holding. What do we see? We see a patch of light on the other side. You know, now the person can adjust the direction of the torch so that the patch of light falls on the second person standing in the room. Wow, interesting to watch, isn't it? So what do we conclude now? The mirror changes the direction of the light that falls on it. Not just the mirror, any other polished and shining surface like a shining stainless steel plate can change the direction of the light. This change of the direction by the mirror or the light coming back after hitting a smooth plane surface is called the reflection of light.
Also, we are having one more activity, that the light always travels in a straight manner and then it gives the reflection. That is the activity we will see. Okay, so whenever you are watching in the mirror, that mirror gives you the same image, or as you are standing in front of the mirror, in the front of the mirror you can see that same picture. Okay, why? Because that plane mirror is always works on this phenomenon of light, that is what, reflection of light. Okay, reflection of light. Okay, so this plane mirror gives us an image. So what is mean by the image? So the image is formed when the light rays falls on an plane mirror, and from that plane mirror it reaches to our images, reaches to our eyes, and then we can see that image. Okay, or we can see that object, or we can see that image. So that image can give all the detailed information about an object. Why is it so? Because on that object, all the light rays falls, then light rays reaches to our eyes directly, and that is the reason we can see the image, or we can see all the details about that image in the plane mirror. Okay, so this phenomenon of the reflection of a light through the plane mirror gives us the one more interesting phenomena, which is called as what? Lateral inversion. Okay, so what is meant by the lateral inversion? We are going to discuss about this, going to discuss through this activity. So let's see this activity.
Lateral inversion of image is defined as the reversal experienced by an image formed in a plane or flat mirror.
When we raise our left hand, the image in the mirror raises its right hand. Our left is the image's right, and similarly, our right is the image's left. So an image follows left-right reversal. So we say that an image formed by a plane mirror is laterally inverted.
So my dear students, now we are discussing about the uses of pinhole camera in nature, mirror and reflection of light, and also we have discussed about the lateral inversion. Okay, so see, reflection of the light gives us image, but the blocking of the light rays gives us what? Shadow. Okay, so see, image is different and the shadow is different. So let's discuss the difference between the image and the shadow. First, when we talk about the color, so the image is giving the same color like an object. So if you wear the blue color clothes and you stand in front of the mirror, then you can see your image in a blue color cloth only. Okay, the image is of the same color as a object, but shadow does not give any information about the color. Shadow is the only dark patch. Next one, that is detail. So the image can give all the details about an object, while shadow does not give any type of the detail about an object. Next one, we will discuss about the lateral inversion. So see, image is showing the lateral inversion. Why the lateral inversion is absent in a shadow? Shadow does not show the lateral inversion. Next one we will discuss, that is formation. So how the image form? When the reflection of the light takes place through the plane mirror or from the smooth surface, then it forms the image. Okay, then it forms the image. Okay, so we can say that the image is formed due to the reflection of the light. But how the shadow form? Shadow is formed when the light rays are get blocked with the help of an opaque object, and with the back of that opaque object we are getting the shadow. Okay, so the reflection of the light forms the image, while the blocking of the light rays forms the shadow. So the size of an image is exactly same as the object. Okay, the size of an image is exactly same as the object, while the shadows, the size of the shadow may get varies, and it depends upon the distance between the opaque object and the screen, and also it depends upon the distance between the opaque object and the source of light that we have seen in previous video. Okay, so all these are the difference between the image and the shadow. Okay, so my dear students, here we have completed all this lesson. Here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.